Hello, I'm Michael Blevins, the redhead known as RunnX. I'm a principal engineer in the technology leadership career path at Optum. Do you want to know how to deploy your ASP.NET Core application as a Docker container to Kubernetes? I'm going to cover how to use Azure DevOps Server to apply a YAML file to Kubernetes, creating a Docker container with the Docker image in Artifactory from my last episode. Hang out and you'll find out. This episode is a continuation from my last episode where I set up a service connection in Azure DevOps Server and created a build pipeline to publish a Docker image to Artifactory. In this episode, I'll configure Azure DevOps Server with a service connection to Kubernetes. Then I'll show you how to create a release pipeline to deploy a Docker container on Kubernetes using that service connection. To provide you a little setup for the demo, I want to let you know that I'll be using a GitHub Enterprise source control repository, Azure DevOps for my build and release pipelines, Artifactory for my Docker image repository, and Kubernetes for my Docker container destination. Okay, here we go. We're going to jump right into the demo. I'm going to go out to Azure DevOps Server. I'm going to add a service connection for Kubernetes. So we'll dive right in by pulling this up and going to my reducing friction team project. I'll go into project settings. We'll dive into the service connections. And you'll see the one that we added in the last episode for Artifactory. We'll come in here and say new service connection for Kubernetes. And here I want to make sure that I've got the right values. So I'm going to take the URL, pop that in there, and I'm going to give it a on-prem K8s. Now, for the next piece, I actually have a configuration that I'll pop in here as well. And we're going to make sure that we accept untrusted certificates. And we're going to make sure that the allow all pipelines to use this connection is actually set. We'll do verify our connection. We see that it is verified. We'll say OK, and that has now saved. So that's the good part. That's easy. The connection's set up. Now we need to go back into our build definition from the last episode and add a couple tasks to make it ready for the release that we'll create. To do that, we're going to go to pipelines builds. We're on the Docker image to Artifactory. I'm going to go ahead and click edit. And in doing so, I can see my agent job, and I'm going to add a couple tasks. The first one will be PowerShell, and the second one is going to be publish artifacts, and I'll change the order just a touch, and we'll configure the PowerShell. So to do what we want here, I want to provide a pretty nice name here. So I'm going to, so it makes sense in the output, I'm going to put in the display name of set version in Kubernetes YAML. And what this is going to do is grab the file that we have in source control and update the latest tag to actually be a value that is from the build. So we need to change the type to inline. And to make that happen, we'll go in here and paste the script. So basically it's going to take the file .NET app deployment YAML, and it's going to replace the latest tag with the build ID and then save that back out to the file. So that's pretty easy, and that task is now configured. We'll go into the publish artifact drop, and we'll go ahead and configure that as well. And again, I want to have a meaningful name so it looks nice in my logs. So I'm going to publish Kubernetes YAML file. And the file that I actually want to publish is that .NET app deployment YAML. And I want to give the name for the artifact YAML. With all those things set, I'm going to save in queue. And that build has now been kicked off. It's waiting for an agent. Once it gets the agent picked up, it will go through and do the build, push the image to Artifactory, and publish that artifact. I can see here now that that has completed. And if I dive into the set version in Kubernetes YAML, I can see that it's generating the script and it ran the script. That's great. And then the published Kubernetes YAML file, I can see that it file upload succeeded, and there's one file that it did. To view that, I can actually go into YAML and look right here at that file by downloading it. Now that file is downloaded, I can open that file up. And you may wonder, what is in this deployment file? So in the deployment file, there is a deployment definition. And that deployment definition is saying what the namespace it's targeting on Kubernetes is, as well as what image it's pulling. And you can see here that it's actually pulling the one that we just built based on that build ID. And if I go in and look at the original source, it says latest here. So that is what that PowerShell script did, was replace that. Another piece you'll see is the service definition here. And basically that's saying, again, the same namespace on Kubernetes, and what port are we exposing on the cluster IP, and what the node or the pod would actually have the target port be. Finally, we have our ingress rule, in which we're going to, again, have our namespace in Kubernetes and what the host is and what port we're actually servicing, having exposed on that service. So with all that in place, I can go ahead and hit close, and we can actually go out here and do a release definition now. So I'm going to pop out. We'll say, all right, let's do a new pipeline. On the right-hand side, you can see the templates that are available. We're going to do a deploy to Kubernetes cluster. So we'll hit apply. And here we're going to give it a nice name. So reducing friction with RunnX continuous delivery. And then we're going to give it a stage name. So this is reducing friction with RunnX Kubernetes stage. We want to add an artifact from our build. So we'll select from the dropdown our source of Docker to Artifactory, and we'll select latest. We'll hit add. And now we can go into the task for the release and actually configure that task. If we go into kubectl apply, we want to make sure that we've got version 1 selected. And we're not using Azure Resource Manager, but we're using Kubernetes Service Connection. And this dropdown is now populated with the one that we created earlier, on-prem K8s. And we need to populate our namespace here for Kubernetes. We are going to do the apply command, but we want to use a configuration file here. So we'll browse. All right. In here, we'll select the YAML. Say OK. And in this particular case, because I'm using a stage environment that has a self-signed cert, I need to add an argument here to insecure skip TLS verify set to true. With that in place, everything else is good. I'm going to go ahead and save. So we've got our continuous delivery or our deployment pipeline set up. I'm going to actually hop out here and do, let's see here. Let's go to our Kubernetes home. In Kubernetes, when I pull this up for our namespace, we've got pods up, but those pods have to do with our ingress rules and tiller and everything like that. So there's nothing out there for our current Docker image to Artifactory image or container that we want spun up. And to also prove that, I want to pull our specific URL and pull that up. We should get a timeout. or actually a 503 service temporarily unavailable. So now what I'm going to do is do a release. That release has been created. All right, so it's on the third of three tasks. The kubectl apply has already occurred. If we hop back out here into Kubernetes and I take a look, you can see that we're now doing another deployment, the Docker image to Artifactory deployment. So we've got 0.3 pods currently up. If I go down here to pods, we can see that we've got two running. We're waiting on the third one. And now we're 100% on our pods, so all three have came up. And right here, I want to make sure I pull this up again. And we've got success. So that is how easy it is to get a release going with Azure DevOps Server and Kubernetes. In closing, I want to thank you for watching this episode of Reducing Friction with RunnX. You can reach out to me in multiple ways, at RunnX on Twitter, LinkedIn, or GitHub, at the redhead known as RunnX on Facebook, or by visiting my contact page on my website, runnx.com. Watch for my next episode where I'll answer a friction request from Jennifer at Optum on how to use Windows authentication for an ASP.NET Core 2.1 application on Azure Pack. I'll also discuss Active Directory options for directory services. Let me know your thoughts and share the friction that you're currently facing in the comments below. And until next time, I'm Michael Blevins. Okay, subscribe somewhere here, turn on the notification, like the video, or tell your friends about the channel. Heck, do all the above. I'd really appreciate it. Later.